What is going on, everybody? It's Alex coming back here with another video, and today we are doing round three of our three-round mock draft. I've been seeing that these videos have been getting a lot of traction, and you guys have been commenting quite a lot. I love that. It's absolutely awesome. You guys have taught me a lot about your teams. I realized I made some mistakes in the draft. Obviously, we're going to fix them. That's why we do a new thing every week. You guys point out flaws. We're perfecting it inch by inch, guys. Every single pick we're doing, trying to make it better and better. You guys teach me a lot. I appreciate the fact that you guys do give me credit because it is kind of hard to know everything about every team. So I do appreciate the fact that you guys do realize that and you guys kind of help me out there. So that's kind of why I love the fact that you guys do comment. It's why I recommend you guys to comment because, I mean, even if it's hate, as long as you just try to put it in a constructive way to where you actually teach me what the fuck's going on, it gets better. So again, if you guys are new, hit that sub button, like, comment, subscribe. Again, our community is absolutely booming. I love it. It is amazing. I cannot believe the fact that we are growing at this rate. And I appreciate the fact that you guys take your time to talk to me and also take your time to actually watch my crap. So I really do appreciate it. Try to get better every day. You guys know the drill. Now, Jets, where are we going to go with you? You guys do need some secondary help. I'm going to be 100% honest here. Do you need a safety? I'm not 100% sold on that. I don't really think so. Do we need a running back? No, we got one, right? So we could be going interior on this offensive line, though, or we could be going pass rush. We know that we got rid of Leonard Williams, who's much more of like an interior threat. But we know that also, since I actually was doing a Jets franchise in Madden, I know that there's actually quite a few guys who, of course, that's like a horrible way to preface me actually trying to say something like constructive. You have a lot of pass rushers, especially outside like edge players that are going to be up for contract. So this is definitely a spot where we can be going for a Jalen Phillips or a Victor. I'm not gonna pronounce that one. But that being said, I mean, I hate always like having to do this because I like Patrick Jones, but I'm mixing both my opinion, NFL's opinion, and TDN's, and obviously TDN is gonna be supreme, obviously, like right now, just because of the fact that they're displaying the rankings. We're down to pretty much Josh Myers, because we can put him at a guard spot. The guard is kind of like, I mean, Van Roten's going to be damn 29, so I don't think he's a long answer there either. We could be going center here. That's 100% a possibility. We could also be going Deonte Brown. I don't think safety is in need. I don't think Vincent's worth this pick right now. I seriously don't. LSU's been getting carved up, but he will be a third-round pick. I just don't think he's worth the reach. Now, an edge player on that path, that could be. But so we're going to be going Patrick Jones here. I think he complements Quinnen Williams actually pretty well. I think that he's much more of a sure thing, higher floor guy. And that's what we're going to be setting up with. So Patrick Jones is going to be the pick here. Again, I think that he could be falling. He could go up into the second. He's going to complement Quinnen Williams very well. Much more of a high floor guy where we thought Quinnen Williams was. But he has a pretty high ceiling as well. Not as high a ceiling as Joe Tryon or I think Jalen Phillips. I think he even has a higher ceiling, but he's an absolute beast. You kind of need some constancy on your team right now. You have some amazing linebacker presence there with, of course, C.J. Mosley coming back. But like adding Patrick Jones to that, you can help out the secondary as well. You know, it's the cornerbacks and the edge players kind of complement each other in a way. If you have good edge, usually the cornerbacks will play better because they're going to be a lot closer and the routes won't develop as much. And then vice versa, the edge can do better if the corners are doing their job. And I think the value is at edge right here. Patrick Jones, absolute monster. Now, Jags again, you need corner. We can't give that to you right now. I seriously am not really in the mood to go down here into the 84th range. You know, it's not a vibe. We have tackles here. We already took one. We have tight ends. Already took one. We could be going interior on the offensive line. Don't really need to, per se, but we definitely could. Again, it says that you need edge presence as well. I guess. You guys went edge in the first round last year. We could be just making you more rich. You might even need a second safety there, because I know we went for a Javon Holland. I'm not 100% sure who your enforcer is, but Paris Ford could definitely be a dude. You don't need running back, so I'm kind of stuck here. If we're going to be 100% fair, I think that maybe getting a surefire, higher floor type of edge might be the right move. And for that, I think getting a guy like Jalen Phillips, I mean, if I'm going to be 100% fair, he kind of reminds me of how Taven Bryan was just much more of like a raw prospect who came kind of out of nowhere, in my opinion. So Jalen Phillips is gonna be the dude. He can definitely fill in and work very well. He's a much more high floor guy, where of course, your first round pick from last year definitely, of course, it steals him from my favorite. I would have loved Jalen Phillips to go here. But Jalen Phillips is gonna be the guy. He's gonna work really damn well with all of your prospects, especially the young ones. So Jalen Phillips, he was able to fill in for Russo very well. I think he's gonna do a very good job here. Now, Bengals, could we even go another interior offensive lineman? Abso-freaking-lutely. We might. Honestly, we might. It might be the most boring draft ever, but you might just go line, line, line. We might not. Save you guys a little bit of hope here. I mean, with how everything's going, you have a guaranteed guy in T. Higgins, as well as a guaranteed guy in Tyler Boyd. Now, Ross is probably gonna be gone. Like, you're not gonna keep him for any bit longer, for that sake. And then AJ Green's pretty much in a casket. He's already like peaced out. So you're kind of lacking that third weapon. We got the line help. I think maybe now it's time to get more of a speed threat. Kadarius Toney. People have been mocking him at the first. I don't think so. I'm a Kadarius Toney fan, and I don't think he's worth that first round. So Kadarius Toney, he's more of a gadget weapon. I think he's kind of what John Ross should have been. So Kadarius Toney, he's going to be running. I think people think he might run like 4-3s. I think he's going to be more of like a 4-4 guy. But that being said, I think he'll add a little bit of a good versatility to this offense. Again, he could be a slot, like a slot mix-up with Tyler Boyd. I don't think so. I think that he has the ability to be more of a gadget player than just a slot guy. Like again, more of like a Ray-Ray McCloud, who again, of course, can probably play a little bit of slot. But I'm just saying, I think the speed can work on the outside. And then, to be honest, I think he'd be a really good complement for Tyler Boyd. I think they're worried about the speed threat of Kadarius Toney and just also the run after the catch ability. And I think he complements that team very well. You need your kind of your really small guy here. Kadarius Toney's going to be a really good player for you. And again, if you don't like these picks, let me know why. Kadarius Toney might be one that's already rubbing me a little bit the wrong way, but it could just be a nice little boost to your team. He could definitely be someone who can play on the outside as well. Cowboys, we could definitely get you some edge presence as well. We could be going into your offensive line because I'm not 100% sure like how good your line is when they're completely healthy, if we're going to be straight up. But we could even be going Daniel Faalela here. I know you guys like to run the ball, and of course, there is always the issue of the fact that your star left tackle always gets injured every freaking year. But you guys have been letting up a lot in the run game, and Christian Barmore has been doing a really good job. But I think I don't know. I'm split between Tyler Shelvin and Christian Barmore here. We could be getting some pass rush as well with Victor Dimukidji. I'm not gonna do that, guys. I'm not gonna do it. I'm not gonna do it. Unfortunately, I'm gonna actually just reach for another extremely raw prospect, but someone who has a shit ton of potential, more than any of these guys. For a team like Dallas that has so much youth, I think they could be in this mode where they can take a guy who has a very high ceiling. Joe Tryon's gonna be the dude. He can play a multitude of roles. He has a lot of energy, and he's just somebody who could pop out of nowhere and be a really dangerous threat. Now, Chargers, you do need interior offensive line help. If I'm not mistaken, I think we took Slater here. Yeah, so we took Slater. We've taken a corner. I think now is a good time to go either center, because I don't Pouncey has one more year on his contract. If actually no, he's on contract year, and he's been injured a lot of times. We don't even know if he's going to be back, for one. Number two, Forrest Lamp has been pretty butt cheeks, as well as whoever the hell has been filled, Dan Feeney. He's been pretty butt cheeks as well. So one of those guard spots is open anyways. Josh Myers has been a very consistent threat, and it's kind of the best player available, right? Even if he doesn't play, he has the ability to eventually succeed Marquise Pouncey. That's going to be an amazing mentor regardless. So Josh Myers is going to be that dude. Now, Panthers, we took a cornerback for you last time. I did not remember that. Oh yeah, we got Asante Samuel. Let's come. That was a great option. You know what? I was like, "What's happening?" I seriously don't know if linebacker is really that big of a need, because your linebackers have been playing a lot better. I will be 100% honest. We could be getting you some protection though. I'm pretty sure your left tackle is he was a former Seahawk, Russell Okung, if I'm not mistaken. I think you got him from the Chargers, actually. Funny that you guys are right next to him. So he's gonna die soon. Greg Little's gonna die soon. I know Moton's on a contract year. you guys kind of do need a tackle. You guys kind of got on me for going tackle last time, but we're going to be going tackle here. When the value's here, the value's here, right? Daniel Faalele is going to be the pick. 6'8", 400 pounds. You just don't really pass up on a dude like that. I've been trying to get him to the Cowboys, but realistically, you know, you kind of signed Everson Griffin at the start of the year for a reason. Of course, you traded him away, but you realize that there kind of is a needed, like, 1-2 punch with DeMarcus Lawrence. Joe Tryon could definitely be a good dude there. Eagles, we all know you guys need some weapons, right? We could even be going Brevin Jordan here if we want. Like, you guys do kind of need a bigger weapon. Dude, Sage Surratt or Seth Williams, you can take your pick here. Even Tylan Wallace could be a great pick. So, for me, I'm higher on Seth Williams than Sage Surratt, to be 100% fair. Not as much separation for Seth Williams, so that might be a little bit of a red flag, because as Eagles fans, you know what happens when J.J. Arcega-Whiteside gets no separation. But Sage Surratt, he's been up and down. And let's check his height. He is 6'2". So I just want to make sure that he wasn't just a 6-foot dude. Like Seth Williams, of course, also same height. These guys are both really talented weapons. Seth Williams has a lot more potential after the catch, in my opinion. And he's been doing it for a lot longer. So that makes me like him a little bit more. However, Sage Surratt has been doing a very great job on the Wake Forest. I don't know why I said on the Wake Forest, on the Demon Deacons for a very long time as well. So they both have really good pedigrees. And to be honest, I kind of think Sage Surratt fits the Eagles a little bit better than Seth Williams. I don't know why. It's just a gut feeling. He was able to compensate for having a pretty garbage quarterback core for his entire career. He's able to put up big numbers and he's good at separating. I mean, he's in the same place as the UNC as well as Clemson. You know, he goes up against very good competition. So Sage Surratt's going to be the dude here. Gets your bigger bodied dude on the outside. Again, you already have Fulgham, but I think getting another outside weapon, because again, we're not keeping Jeffries. That ain't happening. Getting a dude who has a lot of talent on that outside along with Fulgham, and then stick, what's his name, Jalen Reagor in the slot. Man, you could have a really talented wide receiver corps, and we all know everybody's going to get injured, so Sage Surratt's going to have a role regardless. But Sage Surratt's going to be the dude. We're going to stick him in there. Going to do pretty damn well. Now, Washington, I made this mistake last time. I went with good old Hamza Nasir-ul-Din, but of course, totally forgot the fact that you have Landon Collins. Again, you could be moving on from him in the future, but obviously, that's not what's happening right now. You need a true free safety. Andre Sisco is going to be your guy. I don't think Troy Apke is really going to be your ultimate goal, and neither is Sean Davis, for all that matter. Richard LeCount could be a dude here, but I like Andre Sisco a little bit more. I saw actually a huge decrease in Syracuse's production when Andre Sisco left. Versus Richard LeCount, I have my doubts about him, to be 100% fair. He has two of the top corners in the draft helping him out, and that could kind of skew how we view a guy like LeCount, where he's able to be a beneficiary of that. Andre Sisco is not the beneficiary of anything. He's definitely a very highly touted talent, and I think that his only thing that's wrong with him right now is his injury history. So, Lions, now where do we go with you? You need some interior help. We're going to get you some. Tyler Shelvin, I like him more than Jordan Davis, if I'm going to be 100% honest. LSU interior defensive lineman. With Coach O, I mean, Coach O is a fucking D lineman as it is. If you just stick some pads on him, he'll probably be as good as Tyler Shelvin. But, you know, just get some extra help in there. You guys lost Damon Snacks Harrison to Seattle. Just get a little bit of help in there, man. Just get a little bit of help. Your offense has helped out with the two wide receivers, which one of you guys keeps coming at me for that. I mean, you have five dudes on contract. On contract year. This year. You can't re-sign five dudes. So you're probably going to be signing Golladay. I mean, hopefully you do. So now you actually have Jamar Chase, as well as who else did we get? We got like a slot weapon for you guys, right? Just gotta make sure. Oh no, we actually got Zaven Collins. So there you go. You're welcome. We could have went another wide receiver here, if I'm gonna be 100% honest. I forgot about that. But at least you have another weapon, right? So Tyler Shelvin's gonna be at least able to stuff the run. Zaven Collins helped the pass. It's gonna be a nice 1-2 punch with rounds 2 and 3. Now, Falcons, where do we go with you guys? That's a real question. I think we're gonna be going for the linebacker role. And Cameron McGrone has potential to be a Deion Jones. Potential. He's pretty garbage in the run game, but I don't know. With Marlon Davidson there as a former edge, I think that he's going to kind of make up for the run stuffing. He's probably going to be much more of an interior threat. I think that could help. I got a freaking corn kernel stuck between my teeth. It was just extremely irritating. Sorry, guys. That must have been disgusting to watch. But Cameron McGrone's going to be the pick here. Rangy dude. He could pretty much be like a hybrid safety. if you want to think about it. Definitely a lot of talent there, but I'm a little bit skeptical about how much talent McGrone has when it comes to the run game. He kind of gets like messed around a little bit with. Ah, Texans. I mean, we got to help you out in the interior of the offensive line, right? Deontay Brown's just, this is no question. Just get him in there. You need help. Just get some help, man. Broncos, again, I don't think you need a tackle just because Bowles, right? Garrett Bowles, yeah, he's on contract here. Doesn't mean garbage. This is probably where I would have put Karen McGrone, so he probably doesn't get past 76, guys, in the actual draft. So keep your eyes on that. I think that maybe we could be going with a guy like Merlin Robertson. We haven't, you guys really haven't had a stud linebacker core since, man, I forget it every time. I got a damn new, like, platform thing and everything, so the computer doesn't start, the computer fan doesn't go off. Of course, the computer fan's going off. I mean, if you guys want to, we can be getting Brady Christensen here. I seriously don't think it's a need. Let's check out the other linebackers, because if I'm not mistaken, Monty Rice is still on the board. I don't know why the hell they're so down on Monty Rice. I think it's some complete bullcrap. If we're going to be straight up, it's some complete BS. However, interior defensive line could be a need as well. Right now, we're just going to get the best player available, besides Brevin Jordan. And that's going to be Jordan Davis here. You might as well just beef up that interior. You're going to be reaching for a linebacker anyways. So get a dude who, I mean, Jordan Davis is a good guy. I'm not going to blame him at all. Interior defensive line is complete crap. I mean, they literally just signed the D-tackle. Of course, I'm blanking on his name again, from the Ravens. So Brandon Williams, if I'm not mistaken. That I'm totally probably wrong on that one. But you guys need a box safety. Realistically, you need a strong safety. You need someone, you need an enforcer, right? So we're either going to be going Paris Ford or Hamza here. Paris Ford, I think he brings a little bit too much reckless abandon to the table. I don't know. He doesn't feel like a Viking for me. I don't think that he fits the scheme very well. Hamza, on the other hand, that is someone who could fit the scheme. Somebody who I like a lot. 6'4". This says 6'3". This is complete BS. Oh, he is 6'4". Oh, thank God bless. God bless. He is 6'4". Very rangy. He is much more of a box safety and has a lot of range. So I think he's going to be a very highly touted dude, but not many teams really need a box safety right now, so it could have even been to the Broncos if they really wanted to. Don't think so, but Hamza is the dude. Get him there. Now, Washington, we already got a pick for you, so you got another third-round pick. Tell me where that pick's from, by the way. If you guys want to, we could honestly straight up go for Brevin Jordan. I know that Logan Thomas has been playing all right, but realistically, Brevin Jordan's a second-round talent. You're getting him in mid-third. That's a pretty damn good deal. We could be going line here. But I think honestly your line's been playing really well. Again, it's either, to me, it's down to Colby Harvey-Peel just adding another rangy safety, or Brady Christensen or Brevin Jordan. So I'm going to actually throw the Colby Harvey-Peel out of the way. Man, I can't speak today because I just have a hard on for this dude. I love him to death. He's so good. Brady Christensen or Brevin Jordan. Brady Christensen, Morgan Moses is going to die soon, right? It's a pretty much known fact. Morgan Moses is on his deathbed. Brevin Jordan could actually fill a role where there isn't that much talent. Logan Thomas has definitely taken a step forward, and he's definitely a serviceable dude. But with a guy like Trey Lance on the table, you probably want a good weapon to check down to. Brevin Jordan might be that. We already helped out the defense quite a bit. I don't know. I don't really think that we need to go anymore with that route. Brady Christensen, the line could be an issue in long term, but Cornelius Lucas is playing well. I know you guys have some dudes coming up on contract. That's a little bit unfortunate, but you have the money to re-sign them, and I think you should. So keep Moses there. I don't think it's hard for me. This is a really hard pick. This is a spot where maybe I'd trade back, but we're going to be going Brevin Jordan here. Again, if you guys want me to do like a round four, I don't know if I'm going to do that, but I'd be open to the idea. Like, maybe. Just maybe. Just let me know. Brevin Jordan's going to be the dude, though. He's going to add a good versatility. It's a steal. I would have went, this is a good value with Brady Christensen. He's number one graded tackle in the country for PFF, and that's good. That's good. Except he hasn't played really anybody besides at Boise State, and they lost their best pass rusher last year. So I have my concerns. Bears, we could be going some more offensive line here. I know the interior is a little bit weak, and if I'm not mistaken, I'm blanking on the guard's name. We took him from, I believe, Seattle. He's going to be up on contract here. James Daniels doing all right. And then Cody Whitehair, just kick him back to center. He kind of belongs there. We already got our tackle. We need some more line help. Re-sign AR-12, by the way. Zion Johnson is, I mean, BC, they have some amazing fucking guards there. I'm gonna be honest, they have some really good guards. So being able to get him is gonna be a steal. Lindstrom as well, he's a solid dude. But Zion Johnson, I'm gonna trust that he's better than his than the brother of Lindstrom on the Falcons. But you know, Zion Johnson's gonna be a beast. He's gonna just add extra depth to that run game. And you know what? Might as well go back to the glory. Well, that I was about to say something bad. Or let's go back to the Boston College offensive line here again. Now this is where you just take a shot on some dude who will eventually succeed at guard. I think honestly that Richie Incognito has been playing great football throughout his entire career, but he needs a replacement. Again, I don't even. I'm gonna be 100% honest. I don't remember even seeing Richie Incognito play this year. So let me know if he's even playing right now. But that's going to be kind of an issue if that is not the case. Regardless, I think that he's going to be great offensive line depth. Regardless, I said regardless 3 times. You guys like to run the ball. Get a guy from BC who actually knows how to block in terms of running the ball. Now, Vikings, we can go Christian Barmore. That's going to be a great fit. I know you don't need interior defensive line help, but you probably might want it. Looking at quarterbacks, we could be going Desmond Ridder here, but I don't know. I don't know if it's worth it at this point, if we're going to be 100% fair. I'm probably going to pick it for the Browns again, just because Baker's been like the most mediocre dude ever. But he doesn't really fit this scheme pretty much. I don't like him at all. He doesn't fit. And I think that you could get a steal in a potential former first round talent in Christian Barmore. You know, he hasn't taken the leap to Quinnen Williams levels, but he still has like a really solid floor. Definitely someone you could add. And just continue just to gain some more defensive traction, especially when your defense has been playing a little bit subpar. Giants, you need some edge help. Victor is probably going to be your dude here. We're going to be honest. We could be going more of a larger outside receiver as well, maybe a Seth Williams. So let me know in the comment section, of course, what you guys would do. Even Brady Christensen. I know you have Matt Peart, though. Matt Peart's been playing pretty damn well, even though for some reason you guys are splitting snaps with him. I don't know if you guys are still doing that. I'm going to be 100% honest with you. But even left tackle Andrew Thomas doing fine. Obviously not the best year in the world, unfortunately. I mean, I thought that he was going to be the best tackle in the class, arguably. But of course, that's what you get when you listen to other people and don't watch Georgia, right? Now, New York, it's up to you guys to go edge here, get some edge presence. We already got the linebacker, right? We already got the linebacker. We need some edge help. We really want to revamp this defense. It's up to the defense right now. Obviously, the offense is kind of lacking, though. We kind of want a bigger, big threat wide receiver. So, again, let me know down in the comment section what you do. I got Patrick Jones here last draft, but Victor, I've seen some guys even put him into the first. So, there's definitely some good hype here. Mel Kiper likes him a lot. We're going to give you some edge help, right? I think there's some good dudes down the line as well for receivers. There's some good edge everywhere. Of course, my computer is going off, the fan's going off. Hopefully it's not as loud as it was last time. I get so irritated. I try my best, guys. I really do. There's nothing I can do. I just bought like a $70 fucking lap thing so it can get air to the damn computer. It's just the system itself. Now, cards, we could be going linebacker here. I'm not 100% buying that. We're gonna be honest. We could be going some interior presence, but I mean that might not be a bad move given the fact that I mean there's nobody here. So screw that idea as well, for all we care. We're gonna either need a power back because you guys are a zone scheme, but you guys don't really have too much in the name of power. With Javonte Williams, we could be even going Chuba Hubbard if you don't want to re-sign. I am blanking. Oh my God, Kenyon Drake. Kenyon Drake probably won't be even re-signed if we're gonna be honest. He's had a lackluster year, which is kind of a bad time to have a lackluster year when you're on contract. Again, Edmonds has been doing pretty solid, but I don't know if he wants to fully take over that backfield. Chuba could be an all-around player for you. If we're gonna be honest, I think that might be a better move. Save some cap, put it into a linebacker. There's just not enough value here. We're gonna be honest, there's not enough value. We could be putting like a Paris Ford in the box, but I mean, seriously, I don't think that you need that. Like Merlin Robertson could be a guy. I don't know too much about him, but let's just get Chuba here. He's gonna be a solid, versatile weapon. Your line's fine. I don't know why some people are coming at me saying the line's not good. Like, you guys are kind of blind if that's the case. The line's been playing pretty damn well. Just because they add some pressures because Marcus Gilbert decided not to play, it doesn't mean crap. Of course, now the computer's going ballistic on the sound. But it is what it is, guys. Bucks, where do we want to go with you? It's safety, not really a concern. I don't know why they're saying tackle is a concern at all. It really isn't. I know that Godwin is on contract year, though, so I don't know if they can sign him, given the fact they have a lot of other mouths to feed. That might be kind of an issue, but at this point, there's not really a dude I can see that we could genuinely put in that good position. Like an Anthony Schwartz, I don't think that's gonna be a great option. Elijah Moore, maybe. Honestly, it's not a bad pick. We're gonna be 100% like in the open here. I think that would be a pretty solid pick. We could go a backup quarterback as well. I don't really know what the backup quarterback situation for Tampa is, but this is a good spot where we can get Brady's successor, right? That wouldn't be a bad idea. I don't know why they're saying like I think Brady's gonna have like 2 years, and he's gonna be out. I think that's his like graduation plan. You know, get Desmond Ridder to sit behind him for a year and be able to learn. Fuck yeah. So we're gonna be honestly, this is a surprise pick. We're going Desmond Ridder here. You guys might not like that, but I think the upside is just there. Now, Dolphins, you guys missed out on Najee Harris in the first. I mean, in the second round. We're gonna be going Javonte Williams here in the third. He's pretty much just Najee Harris 2.0, just a brute power contact back who has some good agility, good catching skills. He's a very solid all around back. I think he's gonna work amazingly for you guys. Now, Colts, where do we go with you guys? I know that you kind of want more of a boundary corner right now. Not going to be the case. You guys are probably not going to get what you want here. You already have your bigger play threat. You probably want more of a pure slot. Now, I know Paris Campbell offers kind of a slot role with how he likes the like shorter routes, but I don't vibe with that. I don't vibe with that at all. Again, we don't need a running back at all. You don't really need pass rush. Like, if I'm going to be honest, you guys have a really stacked team, hence why I chose them to go to the Super Bowl. Honestly, if we're going to be straight up, you probably want a boundary corner. Kerry Vincent Jr. is probably the best you're going to get. If I'm not mistaken, he actually is a slot corner, though, so we're not even going to vibe with that. So, honestly, I'm pretty happy with the fact I caught that. Elijah Molden would be a solid slot corner as well. We're just not going to vibe with the slot idea. I don't like it. I don't think you guys like it. We already have a big play threat. This is where he kind of like T.Y. Hilton's re regressing big time. We're gonna be honest. Elijah Moore can learn from him. Elijah Moore has like a 97.8 PFF grade in the slot. I mean, he's gonna work really well there. I think he can add a lot. He's gonna add some really good dimensions to this offense. Just somebody who's gonna be really fun. And then again, you know how Mac Jones likes to throw to guys who are like Jaylen Waddle, Devontae Smith, these smaller dudes who have some speed. Have some really good route running. Elijah Moore is just that. I have him as a second round grade. I love Elijah Moore. Now, Browns, you guys could be using a linebacker here. This is where we're going to be taking Merlon Robertson. I think that, I mean, it's just you need it so badly. You guys lost out on probably the only third round quarterback in the draft. So, I mean, there you go. You guys don't really have much else to complain about. These safeties are falling, though. It is a little bit weird for the safeties to fall, especially Paris Ford. I've had him like up in the top of the second. It just is what it is, guys. Now, Rams, we gotta do something with you. We gotta get some help on the offensive line. Brady Christensen's even gonna come in. If you need him to play guard, he can play guard. I know we already got tackle, but the line is just the biggest issue right now. We need youth on that offensive line. We need help. You just need to do everything you can to keep the offensive line healthy. You know, it's not gonna be cooking with the way that the Rams are playing right now, and they invest a lot into their offense and not much into their defense. So this is kind of realistic too. They like to invest in their offense. Get some Brady Christensen up in there. Now, Jets, what do we do with you? Jets, we already revamped your offense. Time to help your defense. Tell me if you really do have a slot corner, because I'm a hesitant to pull the trigger here, because I have a bad feeling that you have a good slot. But strong safety, you have McDougald playing right now, so he's perfectly fine. I don't think you even need this. I know Marcus May's on a contract here, so could we go LeCount and then not sign Marcus May? You have enough money to sign him. I don't see the reason why you wouldn't sign him. So, again, I'm a little bit stuck here. Hunter Long could be a good tight end option, but Jack Sanborn could be a dude. Let's check out the linebackers. Honestly, with how well your linebackers do play, dude, getting a 6'7" rangy linebacker could be worth reaching. It's not a reach, guys. It's just some BS. He gets a little bit beat up in the run game. He's a lean dude. He's 6'7", 235. It happens. But he's really good at coverage, and to me, that's a little bit scary. Just seeing how high his potential is, that could offer a shit ton of value to this team, especially a team that kind of needs to retool. Charles Stone's going to be able to learn how to play the run game from CJ Mosley as well. I think the sky's the limit for this guy. Definitely the best situation possible. Give him as much help as he can, and that's going to be a really, really beneficial system, especially with all the pass rushers and linebackers on contract. Just obviously, it's just going to be a high upside place for him. Now, Titans, where do we go with you? I think you guys could be going for safety. If I'm not mistaken, one of you guys did tell me that you were looking more for the strong safety type. And, I mean, Paris Ford could be that dude for you. Again, TDN's not saying that for you guys, so I'm going to be shying away from that for now. I know you guys probably want Adoree Jackson in the slot or Christian Fulton, so you probably don't want another slot guy. But it could be. I mean, if you want to stick Adoree still on the outside, keep Adoree on the outside, keep Kerry Vincent on the outside, and then put Kerry Vincent on the inside, and then I'm blanking on the dude from LSU, Christian Fulton on the outside. I think that can work dividends. I think these guys who you traded for are kind of like bandages, like one and dones. So I don't think you're going to be re-signing anything. Honestly, Kerry Vincent could be a dude for you. I think you guys are going to be re-signing Corey Davis, especially after his brother died. It's kind of a PR thing, but he has been playing really well. Kerry Vincent Jr. is going to be able to go in the slot. I know you guys probably want one of the dudes you already have there in the slot, but I think you have the talent to kick him outside, keep him outside, and then just have such good youth. And Kerry Vincent, just play with Christian Fulton. You have instant chemistry there. So I like him a lot. Let's go Kerry Vincent here. Now, I mean, these safeties are falling. I hate this. I hate this so much. The Bills, you guys do need some tackle help. We're going to be going Spencer Brown here. If I'm going to be 100% honest, like, I'm not 100% sure of what your entire offensive line's looking like right now. So you probably might not need that. But you guys run the ball so damn much that there's a high chance that you probably need an offensive line. And I'm going to trust TDN on this one. Bills fans, please let me know what's up with that. You guys know far better than I do. Pack, do we need a rangy safety? No. Do you need an enforcer? No. It's kind of annoying, but where do we go? You guys do need some interior presence. You guys have Kenny Clark, and that's pretty much it on that interior. I just talked to one of you guys the other day. So we're going to be going Haskell Jarrett here. Give some help on the interior. You guys have been actually kind of, if I'm not mistaken, you guys have been peeled apart in the run game. So getting a guy from Ohio State could definitely help with that. Chiefs, you don't need a safety either. Like, what's up with the safeties falling, man? This is kind of irritating. We could be going right tackle because you guys are kind of losing out on that. Tevin Jenkins could be the dude here. And if we're going to be honest, I think he is the dude. Why not? Get some extra protection for your half-a-billion-dollar man. You need to invest in it all you can, right? Now, Browns, we're here again? What the hell? We're here again. You guys are accumulating picks, and it's slightly irritating. But do we have, like, Washington, they have some, I mean, Vita Vea has been there. Obviously, we just drafted Joe Tryon. They have some good interior presence, and we drafted some edge. We could be going interior as well. I don't really know. There's not really too much wrong with your team besides that linebacker core. Like, realistically, it's why I chose you to go to the AFC Championship. I seriously don't know why your team's underperforming besides your quarterback. So, realistically, we could be taking a quarterback here. Again, the only guy I can see going here is probably Brock Purdy or Sam Ehlinger. That's it. And that's a little bit sketchy to me because I don't want to reach that far. Yeah, I don't think you do that in the third round. So, again, we're going to be pulling back from that option. Could we use a big number one wide receiver, though? Maybe. I know that Peoples Jones, if I'm not mistaken, 6'2". And you definitely have the dudes who are probably the size of Seth. But do you have the enforcer like Seth? I don't know. You definitely don't have the speed, per se. If I'm not mistaken, you don't really have too much of a speed burner. So that, to me, kind of like, that puts somebody like Tylan Wallace on the market. Or Anthony Schwartz. I think he could work really well in this game. If I'm not mistaken, Odell Beckham Jr.'s last year in Cleveland is probably going to be this year. He just hasn't been vibing along, not fitting with the system, and wasting his talent. I think that he's not going to like that either. So it's either Tylan Wallace, who's a super weapon with some speed, or Anthony Schwartz, who's just a speed burner. And I think, honestly, Tylan Wallace is going to be just too good of a pick to pass up. He legit could be like an Odell Beckham Jr. type. He's so good. Now, Steelers, we all know we need some help in the run game. It's either going to be down to, I mean, Muhammad Ibrahim is a little too much like our boy Benny Snell, so that's a little bit sketchy to me. Zeus, I don't know. Kenny Gainwell, honestly, to me, I'm a little bit lower on him than 86, but not lower than probably 95. we're gonna be honest here. Kenny Gainwell has he's done a pretty damn good job. He's a multi-versatile back. You know, we got the line. You know, I mean, cornerback could be a thing we go after, but again, just like we don't need a slot. We already have Sutton. We already have Hilton there. We don't need a slot. So Elijah Molden, we're kind of losing out. But realistically, this could be a place where we go quarterback. Not really. Let's go Kenneth Gainwell. You know, definitely somebody who I think he could be a Steelers dude. He's an all-around back. He's not going to be like one or the other like Antonio McFarland and Benny Snell. He's definitely a hybrid. I think he worked really well with them. Again, Zeus is a little too much like Benny Snell to me. Now, Patriots, we've gotten so much for you guys. It's time for you guys to get a legit weapon. Not Richard LeCount, Colby Harvey-Peel. He is such a good free safety. I think he's going to be I think he's better than all of these dudes. He's going to be so good. He fits so well. Man, I'm kind of jealous of y'all. Again, Colby Harvey-Peel is just such a good value. Now, Chargers, this is where we could get an edge. We're still stuck in safety. We could be getting an edge here, if we're going to be honest. I could go Jack Sanborn here. That could be a dude for us. But, I mean, with Cincinnati, Cincinnati edges are so good. We're going to be a Majai Sanders here. Just imagine him. He can learn from a guy like, obviously, Bosa. That's going to be a really solid dude. Of course, you have Uchenna Nwosu. But, again, he's going to be coming up with contract soon anyways. Might as well see if you got the youngster and just, you know, take a shot, right? Might as well. I'm not going to, can't really, like, screw up getting a third-round pick that much. It's not like it's going to be the end of the world, right? Now, Saints, this is where we could, I mean, there's no corners available. There's no quarterback available. There's safeties available, but you don't really need a safety. So we're kind of stuck here. Brenton Cox has actually been having a really good year, but we're going to be reaching for Shaka Toney here. Reaching. He's on one of the best tandem edge rushes in the country. You can put him up with Cam Jordan. You can put him up with Marcus Davenport. Adding that just helps so much. Just getting the rotation. Keeps them healthy, too. Increases their longevity. And this is what you do in the third round. You honestly, you get your own value, and then you help your team's value by helping everybody else on your team already. That's going to help out a lot. Now, Cowboys, we'd be going interior for you guys. It's unfortunate that you guys went safety. Now, I mean, we could be going safety again. Who do we go? We went Morig. Morig's much more that enforcer type over the field. This could be a place that Richard LeCount goes, if I'm going to be honest. Richard LeCount, it's kind of too good to pass up at this point, and there's not any other route that I would go. Let's go Richard LeCount. You have your free safety now. You have your strong safety now. So I think that's going to be a very good duo there. I think it's going to just add a lot of value, and it's going to be worth the pick. Paris Ford's falling. It's kind of pissing me off, but it is what it is, guys. Rams, where do we go with you? There's no really offensive like line issues. I mean, offensive line weapons that we could go. We already drafted two offensive linemen. Can we go edge again? I think we can go Brenton Cox here. I don't know if Leonard Floyd is going to be there for much longer. We might have just signed a deal with him, but definitely not something where we need to. Honestly, we're going linebacker, though. It's a pretty big need. You lost, I'm bugging, on the Raiders, Corey Littleton last year. So getting Pete Warner could definitely come in and do a pretty damn good job. It's kind of like Malik Harrison from this last draft, just much more of a... Ohio State just allows some pretty damn good talent just to sit there in the middle rounds for their linebackers. Definitely something that the Rams could pick up and help out their defense, right? Now, we got Titans again. Man, you guys have so many damn picks. This is like where I'm a little... this pick I'm a little bit confused on. We're going to be straight up. I'm a little bit confused on where to go. Could we get another... We could get a more of a elusive catchback. I know that you guys do have some dudes there already, but I don't know if they're actually the best options. If I'm going to be 100% honest. They seem more like waiver wire type of guys. Seth Williams is honestly too good to pass up, though. He is a little bit too much like Corey Davis, but in that case, I mean, just have two Twin Towers there. That's the way we're going to end the draft. I don't think a Corey Davis can fall out of the third. You know, it's just like, that seems like a little too good to me. And again, if you guys want to move on from Corey Davis, that could be your route. So let me know what you guys think. Obviously, this third round is a little bit more questionable than the other ones in my mind. I'm not 100% confident in how everything went. But, of course, I want you guys to speak your mind. Thank you guys so much for all the subs and everything. I really do appreciate it. It's awesome. It's such a confidence boost. I'll see you on the far side. Peace.